Rann of Kachchh is a seasonal marshy salt desert. During monsoons, the marsh fills up with water, and in summers, the water dries to create a crunchy salt bed. In the oldest texts of the Rigveda, Saraswati River is described as a great and holy river in northwestern India. In post-Vedic times, it was described as powerful and mighty river draining into Rann of Kachchh.
The one line which you can see the distinct rocky landscape as well as the flat run surface. So that distinct geomorphic expressions which you can see, which actually is the tectonic boundary. The Kachchh mainland fault runs exactly on that boundary. So this, as you know, we are on the uplifted landscape of the Kachchh mainland, and the part of the run which is the half graben surface, which is filled by the tertiary as well as the quaternary sediments. So if you see the difference of this sediments and that sediment, they are all quaternaries filled by the river actions from the Himalayan river systems, as well as the sediments which comes from the Kori Creek, almost some few 90 to 100 kilometers from, you know, I think it is 40 kilometers,
hardly 40
kilometers. So this run is a present day geological basin. So for the layman, for the geologist, this run is a really a marvel for the research in the particularly for the quaternary sediments.
We are standing at the highest point in Kachchh, that is the Babia peak on the Pacham hill, and on the background you can see the Great Run of Kachchh. So the Great Run of Kachchh is a very saline terrain, and it gets submerged from high tides and from the high precipitation during the monsoon seasons, and that water remains there for some time actually. So still there is some sea water that has come inside, that is there in the background. This sea water comes from the western end, where this basin is connected to the Arabian Sea. So this periodic inundation imparts the salinity to this particular terrain. Now geologically this is important because historical evidence also is there, and there is geomorphological evidence also to say that the Great Run of Kachchh was occupied by a sea at least during the last 10,000 years. Now this particular terrain has a flat characteristic, so carrying out geological studies is not really very easy. You need to access the sediments to reconstruct the geological history of the Great Run.
Harappan civilization thrived along Saraswati River system, and their decline migration is linked with the demise of the river. Ancient town of Dholavira in the Rann of Kachchh is one of the five largest Harappan sites.
See the Harappan period, maybe around 5,000, 6,000 years back, this entire region used to be the area which was the navigated by the shallow sea kind of systems. And the Harappan people from far western side, they used to have the connections with the Harappan sites which are found in the Kachchh mainland and entire Kachchh. Maybe around 150 sites we found the early to late Harappan sites. They had connections with the original Indus civilization sites. So these run used to be a part where people used to have navigation. So for the cultural aspects, the run is a very interesting area.
We have excavated the early Harappan archaeological site. So it is basically a cemetery or a graveyard where almost more than 250 graves have been excavated, and we have excavated out the whole of the bodies. Then we have excavated bangles, we have excavated potteries which were part of the rituals that was being deposited, and then we are also we have also found the graves. The orientation of the graves is mostly in the north-south direction, and they are in the form of rectangular. Some are also in the form of circular graves are there. Then in from these graves we have also found various ornaments like beads, then shell bangles and all those things. And also we have found a whole bovine grave was also excavated out from this place. So that means like this was a big graveyard, and based on this graveyard we can assume that there must be some big or residential complexes also which must be here of the early Harappan age. And in that way like Pardapet is there, and one has been found in the Lakhapur area also. So in short we can say that this archaeologically this area is very rich, and we have found the late early Harappan structures and early Harappan graves, and which has also been dated to be around 4800 years old. So this is very rich archaeologically also.
Some 20 kilometers from here there is Harappan fort. Of today's then currency of the 300 years back. So this 1 lakh kori per day they used to collect the customs, and more than 8 lakh kori per month they used to collect from the rice which they cultivated from here. This rice all of a sudden vanished because of the Jharamara Yudh. Ulamsa Kalora came. We had a battle of Chara here at this place.
But by the Mahabharata time, Saraswati River dried up in the desert. A number of archaeologists and geologists have identified the Saraswati River with the present-day Ghaggar Hakra River, or the dried-up part of it in western India. Geologists successfully searched the sediments brought by the ancient Saraswati River and deposited in Rann of Kachchh.
Geological problem that needs to be identified is that how so much thick volume of sediment was deposited. So based on the two deep cores, about 60 meters and 50 meters, we analyzed the sediments for the strontium neodymium isotopes in collaboration with the Physical Research Laboratory, Ahmedabad. And these studies show that the sediments here are different from the Indus Delta. Previously, there was a notion that the Indus sediments were redistributed within the run margin. But then this study show that the sediments are very different. Whereas the Indus sediments, they are brought by the Indus River, which is a trans-Himalayan river. So the sediments from the other side of the Himalayas, their signal is there. But here in Great Rann of Kachchh, the isotopic signal is of the lower Himalayas. So the source of the sediments is dominantly from the lower Himalayas. Some drainage needs to be there, how the sediments were brought here. So obviously we can relate them with the Saraswati River. The previously also the existence of the Saraswati has been found out based on geomorphological evidence. There are pilu channels, etc. And this river rose in the lower Himalayas, and that debouched from the northern margin of the Great Rann of Kachchh. So obviously this drainage system was responsible for the bringing the large volume of sediments into this basin. The fine-grained nature of the sediments also suggests that the sediments have undergone very long transport. There is very little role of the local sedimentation from the Kutch and mainland or from the Aravalli actually. So this proves the this gives a scientific evidence that the Saraswati did exist actually. And there is a within the core there is a weakening of the this isotopic signal at about 6,000 years. There's a gradual weakening. So that possibly can be related to the demise of the Saraswati River. And later on then the Indus input dominates actually. So the study has an important bearing on this. Now the questions that need to be addressed is how this submergence of the river, submergence of the basin within the sea, and how it was related to the Indus civilization. That questions need to be answered still.